The results of elections to UP and other states have taken political analysts by surprise. There has been such a big reversal from the trends that had been emerging during the past couple of years that political analysts are struggling to find the reason for this reversal. Many say that this is a rejection of casteism, communalism, and pseudo-secularism. Many say this is a vote for development. But I think the one single factor which has resulted in this mandate is the demonetization done by Prime Minister Modi ji. Demonetization caused hardships. It also caused slight setbacks to the GDP, and businesses were affected. But in spite of that, it had a tremendously positive impact on the psyche of the nation. The people of the country for the first time felt that here was a Prime Minister who was ready to put his political career on stake in order to experiment with something about which he was convinced. People might have felt that the step was wrong or not taken properly or could have been scheduled in a different way, but they were convinced of his sincerity. And this happened in a nation where for the past 70 years people had made, politicians had made, leaders had made very morally uplifting speeches about abolition of corruption. But the same politicians, the same leaders had opened the back doors of their houses to collect huge amounts of corruption money. It is Modi ji's sincerity that has been rewarded through this election result. Unlike most state elections, the mandate is like a national mandate to the extent that it covered a large part of India. Of course, the listener of this video may say, what about Punjab? The setback in Punjab is not for the BJP, because BJP is hardly a presence in Punjab. It is like the Congress in Tamil Nadu. So any setback in Punjab has to go to the Akali Dal. The people of Punjab are now giving a chance to the Congress under Shri Amarinder Singh ji to bring down the Udta Punjab to the land, back to the earth, back to the ground. Now, the public of Punjab and the people of the nation will be watching how effectively he is able to do that. So this election is essentially a national mandate at the level of five states. There had been earlier elections, J&K, Bihar, and other elections, Delhi, where the BJP suffered setbacks because caste mathematics, communal mathematics, and incrimination, use of allegations worked with the people. But now, the sincerity of Modi ji to to throw out the system of corruption won the people's heart across castes, across religions, to such an extent that nothing else mattered, nothing else worked. This is a big lesson for the political parties, including the BJP, because the people have now put their faith in Modi ji, and they naturally expect him to take bigger steps now, to take more vigorous steps now. The people rejected allegations that Modi ji had given money or had favored his friends during the demonetization step. They did not pay heed to criticisms that Modi ji failed in bringing the money stashed in foreign countries and has therefore started a demonetization within the country as an eyewash. The people knew that there were genuine difficulties in bringing money from abroad, and therefore Modi ji has taken the next practical step. So this is now a mandate given to Modi ji to go forward on the path that he took on 8th of November 2016. This election has resulted in further marginalization of the Congress. The Congress will have to now seriously consider its leadership crisis. The election has also shown disillusionment with the Aam Aadmi Party. The Aam Aadmi Party, in a way, has over the past couple of years developed as a party which has taken the worst in other parties. It has taken the agitationist approach of the communists, the exploitation of casteism, communalism of the Congress, and to some extent making huge promises. To some extent this is taken from the BJP, but the difference is that the BJP has at least partially fulfilled its promises. In my opinion, the Aam Aadmi Party is now on the way out. I don't think they have a platform on which they can proceed further, because they have failed to prove themselves to be a party with a difference. They talk of abolishing caste, abolishing communalism, and then indulge in the worst type of casteism and communalism. They indulge in the worst type of opportunism. Now I think the future lies with the BJP. The BJP should now gradually focus on cleaning itself, cleaning the system, taking the country forward. The BJP is blessed with a leader who is a leader with historical presence. He is a leader the like of which not only our nation but most other countries have not had the good fortune of having. I am confident that today's election result is going to bring about very positive changes in our country and is going to set trends that will transform our nation into a big power. Thank you very much.